Now let us see some of the examples of mitigation plan. Actually, yesterday we discussed this issue, that is too many requirement changes. This is, if this is the issue, what is the mitigation plan? Okay, this is an example for mitigation plan, and the issue is too many requirement changes from the client. If that is the case, we need to convince the client that, so now in the middle of the project you are coming with the requirements and it is having impact on the project. So it may hamper the overall budget and it may delay the overall delivery schedule. So that we have to convince to the client. That is one mitigation plan. And you have to define a procedure for requirement changes. That means you should make it very clear to the client that, so at what stage of project development they can come up with the requirements. They see, you should not allow them to come with the new set of requirements whenever they want. Okay, for that you need to have a clear procedure when they can come up with new set of requirements. That is in the beginning of the, in the beginning stage. Okay, once you deliver one iteration of the software, immediately they can come and give their requirements. So that should be the procedure. Then maintain cumulative impact of changes and make it visible to the client. Students, here the meaning is that, say if the client comes with some requirement, you should calculate what is the effort required. Then at the same time, you should calculate its impact. What is the impact? Say for example, impact could be say 1 week delay in delivery, software delivery. And say for example, some 0.5% increase in overall budget. So that is called as the impact. That means it is having impact on the budget as well as the delay. So as well as the delivery date. Then maintain cumulative impact of changes and make it visible to the client. When you have to maintain cumulative impact means when they come up with too many requirements. So for requirement one, what is the impact? You document it. For requirement two, what is the impact? So that is, what is this requirement one and two? They are the new set of requirements which they are coming and asking to implement somewhere in the middle of the project. Then negotiate payment on actual effort. So you have to negotiate the payment on actual effort. Why? Because they are suggesting so too many changes, and as a company, when you are implementing those changes, obviously there should be negotiation of payment. And another example is manpower attrition. This is very, very important because they are the major source, and this manpower is responsible for implementing the project, isn't it? Ensure that multiple resources are assigned on key project areas. That means, so wherever you identify implementing certain requirements as critical, there you allot extra resources so that if one leaves the company, so remaining people can cope up and they can finish off the job without much headache. Then have team building sessions. Team building sessions are very helpful, and as part of team building sessions, what they discuss is, they discuss about the criticality in implementing the project and major issues that are to be addressed and the procedures that are to be followed to address the issues. So therefore, team building sessions are very much helpful. Then rotate jobs among team members. See, the whole purpose of rotating the jobs among team members is that, so everyone knows everything. To implement that concept of everyone knows everything, so the rotation is very much important. Keep backup resources in the project. So there cannot be any project without backup resources. So backup resources are very much important to finish off the project in stipulated time. Because we cannot assume that, say for example, in the beginning of the project, there are 50 members in the project. We cannot ensure that until the delivery of the project, all 50 members will stay in the company. Isn't it? We cannot ensure. So that's why always keep backup resources. Maintain documentation of individuals' work. Then follow the CM. What is this CM? Change management process. Yes. So for more clarity, yes, I'll make it change management. Because suddenly if you look at the terms, we get confused. Follow the change management process and guidelines strictly. Okay. next example, unrealistic schedules. See, unrealistic schedules are prepared when, say for example, when a project manager or a technical lead, okay, is not having sufficient experience in that domain. That means in terms of developing similar projects, obviously they can come up with unrealistic schedules, which is very bad. So negotiate for better schedule. So what is the solution for that? When the schedules are unrealistic, say for example, you're the software engineer and your team lead has given some schedules. Once if you feel the schedules are unrealistic, say for example, to implement certain task, it requires complete 1 week, but they are giving you 4 days. So as a developer, you have to negotiate for better schedule. You have to convince them how much critical it is to implement, and you have to take extra time to implement. So that is called negotiation. Then identify parallel tasks. That means, see, many times you can do certain things in parallel. For example, see, whenever we do automation testing, first we write the testing and we write the automation code. We prepare the test data and we link it with the Excel file or from wherever it has to pick the test data. Then we'll run, once we start running the script, it will take a lot of time. So at that time, instead of simply sitting idle, we can do some tasks in parallel. So parallelly, the automation task will keep happening, and at the same time, we can utilize our effort to do some other meaningful task. Then have resources ready early. See, if you want to do any work, you should set up the resources very much early so that you can start everything in time. Identify areas that can be automated. Okay. So when we say project, it is not like everything can be automated. Only certain things can be automated, and we have to identify such things that which can be automated. If the critical path is not within the schedule, negotiate with the client. Okay, that is very, that is once again with respect to the schedule. If you feel it is unrealistic, if the schedule is unrealistic, or due to some of the changes they have suggested somewhere in the middle of the project, then you have to convince with the client and you have to negotiate. Then negotiate payment and actual effort. Okay, so obviously when you implement new requirements, you have to negotiate the payment on actual effort. Now look at what is risk mitigation plan. Risk mitigation involves steps that are to be performed, hence has extra cost. Yes, always mitigation plans comes up with added cost. It is not a paper plan. These steps should be scheduled and executed. That means this is just not a theoretical plan. It has to be implemented. Then only it becomes mitigation plan. So with the overall idea of mitigation plan to reduce the overall impact of the particular risk. And these are different from the steps one would take if the risk materializes. They are performed only if needed. So mitigation plans are executed only if needed. Risks must be revisited periodically. That means from time to time, you have to reassess, are there any risks in this project? So let us see a practical risk management approach. Based on methods of some organizations, okay, so how to implement risk management approach practically. List the risks for each risk rate probability as low, medium, high. Once again, the same procedure. For each risk, assess impact of the project as low, medium, and high. That means once again, we are taking into consideration what we did in the previous class, risk rate probability and the impact. And we are giving them the values low, medium, and high. Then rank the risks based on probability and impact as HH is the highest and LL is the lowest, isn't it? Say if I say LM, that means risk probability is low. That means the chance of occurrences of the risk is very low. And M means the impact is medium, like that LM means. Select top few items for mitigation. Okay, so one way of practically tackling with this risks is to check it over, to check the probability of a risk. If it's having more chances of risk, if there are more chances of risk, then give the value high. If it is nominal, give the value medium. If the chances are very less, give the value low. Similarly for the impact. Now look at the example of risk management plan. See, when you get a question about risk management, so one thing, the three things are very important: the meaning of risk management plan, then what is the approach for risk management, then example. So these three things you have to write. Students, once again I repeat, definition of risk management plan and the what is the practical approach, then example. Now look at here. So they have given four risks. So that is failure to meet perfect requirements, lack of people with right skills, complexity of the application, and unclear requirements. Then they have given the probability. So for example, failure to meet perfect requirements. So the probability of occurrence of that risk is very high. Why? Because see, when you document the requirements, always there are chances, because when the client is telling too many requirements, always there are chances of somewhere missing some of the requirements. So give the priority as very high. So the probability of occurrence is very high, and impact is also very high. Why the impact is very high? Because just before the delivery, that means the client, just before accepting the software, he will ask you to submit the acceptance testing report. So during that acceptance testing, the client will be preparing the test data and the test cases, and you will be just exercising the test cases. So at that time, you will come to know that something is not implemented, isn't it? So obviously, so the impact is very high, okay? And the exposure is very high. So this is risk exposure. The last column is risk exposure is very high. Then lack of people with right skills. So the probability of occurrence of that thing is medium. Okay, sometimes, somewhere here and there, say for example, somewhere we may feel, okay, we don't have right people who can do automation. Okay, so quickly we can hire someone, or if we have any backup, so or if we have any excess team members in some other project who is doing automation, we can bring them and we can explain what is our requirements. So it doesn't take much time. So the impact is medium. Okay, exposure is also medium. So what should be done when there is lack of people with right skills? We have to provide training, or we have to hire, and we have to clearly explain them what is our requirements, isn't it? So that they will gear up as soon as possible, to implement the task. Then complexity of the application. So most of the times, every company try to minimize the complexity within the application. Okay, when you are developing an application with too many features, then there can be complexity. Okay, and that is usually that will be medium. Okay, probability is medium and impact is also medium. So then unclear requirements. So most of the times, when the client use the requirements, you'll be converting that into requirements document. So then that will be shown to the project manager, not technical lead, everyone. Then once again, it will be shown to the client for approval. So somewhere, if there are any, if they feel something is unclear, so they will chart out, isn't it? So the probability is medium, impact is medium, and also the exposure is medium. So this is one example of risk management plan. Next, we'll see project monitoring plans. So first we need to understand what is the meaning of project monitoring. See, the meaning of project monitoring is, so to have a track on what is the current state of the project. Say for example, in terms of effort, how much percentage of the effort is already, okay, so spent, how much of effort is put into the project already. How much of effort is spending? Okay, then in terms of requirements implementation, how many are implemented, how many are still pending? Okay, and also monitoring in terms of budget. So to this much So say for example, so already 75% of the requirements are implemented. So what is the budget spent already? Okay, so also to track such things, project management is very, very important. A project monitoring plan is a mere document that can guide all these things. Now, whatever I told, it must be executed compulsorily. If you do not execute project monitoring plans, obviously you will fail to give updates to the client. They will ask you updates once in 2-3 weeks. Sorry, once in 2-3 days. And obviously at the weekend. To ensure execution goes as per plan, it must be monitored and controlled. Yes, it must be monitored and it's a controlled process. Controlled process means, say for example, there is some lagging in a certain team. Okay, then we have to motivate them, okay, to complete as soon as possible. So in that sense, it is monitored and controlled process. Monitoring requires measurements. Okay, so what is to be measured? Just I told. So number of requirements implemented and pending. So the percentage of effort already put. Okay, and pending effort and such things. And methods for interpreting them. And monitoring plan has to plan for all the tasks related to monitoring. In the coming slides, we'll see what are the tasks that are related to monitoring. And now we'll see what are the measurements. Project monitoring plan must plan for measurements in a project. Without planning, measurements will not be done. So what to measure? Main measurements are effort. The very first thing is effort. That has to be measured. Then size. Size means the size of the project. See, there are so many ways to measure the size of the projects depending upon number of modules, then number of lines of source code and so on. So these are the very two common approaches to measure the size of the project. Then schedule. So how to measure the schedule? Say for example, you will put say January to March. Okay, one particular phase of the software development life cycle should be completed. Okay, that's one example to track the schedule, whether the things are going as per schedule or not. Okay, like that. And defects. Okay, defects tracking. So as and when the defect arises, that should be addressed, okay, based upon its severity and priority. Then effort, as this is the main resource often tracked through effort reporting tools. There are effort reporting tools using which we can track it. So one example is Microsoft Project. One such tool is Microsoft Project. Keep in your mind. Then defects, as they determine the quality. See, if there are very less defects, means the software is of very high quality. If there are too many defects, then it is of very low quality. The software is of very low quality. So they often determine the quality. Often defect logging and tracking systems are used. Okay, the very best example for that is project management tools like Jira, Confluence, Wrix. Those are the examples which are used for defect logging and tracking. And also one more popular tool you might have heard about Bugzilla. Bugzilla is one ideal tool which is used for defect tracking. During planning, that will be measured how tool support and data management. During planning, okay, it addresses what will be measured, how it will be measured, and what is the tool support, and and how to manage the data. So all these things will be measured. Then project tracking, what is the goal? The goal of project tracking is to get visibility in project execution, so corrective actions can be taken when needed to ensure project succeeds. That means the project execution should be a transparent process. So that we can get some visibility about what is happening. And if required, suitable actions can be taken so that the project will succeed in stipulated time. Then different types of monitoring done at projects, measurements provide data for it. Okay, there are different ways of monitoring a project. Okay, and measurements provide data for that. Okay, so the meaning of different types of monitoring is, say, monitoring in terms of number of requirements implemented and number of requirements pending. That is one way. And tracking in terms of effort, what already we have put. Say, for example, total effort required for the project is, say, 12,000 hours, 12,000 man hours. So if already 8,000 man hours of effort is already put, then 25% of the work is pending, like that. So there are different types of monitoring that can be done. Now let us have a close look at what are the activities. Okay, so and how it will be tracked. So when we see, there are under tracking, there are two things. One is activity level monitoring, and another one is status reports. So at activity level monitoring, each activity in detailed schedule is getting done. Okay, each activity in detailed schedule is getting done, and often done daily by managers. That means, so how to track the activity each and every day? That will be tracked by the team leads, and team leads will be reporting to the managers. A task done marked 100%. Tools can determine status of higher level tasks. Okay, what tools can determine higher level tasks means project monitoring tools. Then status reports, generally done weekly to take a stock of how much work is already progressed. Then summary of activities completed pending. So that status reports have to be generated. Then issues to be resolved. Okay, so therefore the reports will be prepared for, generally done weekly to take the stock, then summary of activities completed and pending, and issues to be resolved. Then another thing is milestone analysis. So how to do the main milestone analysis? A bigger review at the milestones. See, when you do certain number of works, you can achieve one milestone, isn't it? It is not like if you do one work, one task, you can achieve one milestone. It is not like that. If you do a set of tasks, related tasks, then you can achieve one meaningful milestone. Say, for example, if you talk to the client, okay, you can do formal interview, informal interview with the client. Then you can document the user stories. Then you prepare user requirements, then convert them into system requirements, then add domain requirements, limitations, everything. Then it becomes one requirements document. That is one milestone. Okay, so before preparing that requirements document, you have to do a lot of exercises. So many tasks you have to do, then only you can achieve the milestone. Okay, so you have to, so as part of tracking, so always the review at milestones is very much essential. Then actual versus estimated for effort and schedule is done as part of milestone analysis. Say, for example, for requirements, if you have to, like, as per the detailed schedule, the time given for requirements phases, say, for example, 45 days. Okay, and the actual time taken is, say, for example, 42 days. Okay, so then there are, okay, so almost, okay, there is no, okay, some 2 to 3 days gap is there, no? So that has to be adjusted, isn't it? So what happens as a, see, since you have finished requirements 3 days earlier than expected, so you get some breathing time, okay, to deal with design phase. Is okay, like that. Then risks are revisited. That means once you, like, say, for example, resolve some issue, once again, you have to revisit whether it is 100% resolved or not. Then changes to product and their impact may be analyzed. If you do any changes, what could be the impact on the overall product? Okay, and that has to be analyzed. Because what happens sometimes when you do some modification in one module, and that module may be having so many dependencies with other modules, so that impact has to be assessed properly. And it requires a lot of changes in the source code, and that has to be done. So that is actually a real risk. Then cost schedule, milestone graph is another way of doing this. Okay, cost schedule is also another way. Okay, for you will be scheduling cost. So for this phase, this much cost. For, okay, like that. For each and every phase, you'll be assigning. Okay, you will be having certain fixed amount, isn't it? So that has to be reviewed. Next is PMP, Project Management Plan. It is called as PMP, Project Management Plan. It contains outcome of all planning activities, focuses on overall project management. See, overall project management means, which includes dealing with the schedules, budget, resources. Okay, resources means tools as well as human resources, everything. Besides project management, PMP means project management plan, a project schedule is needed. Okay, besides PMP, a project schedule is needed, which will reflect what activities get done in the project. Microsoft project, that is called as MSP. In industry, they call it as MSP. Microsoft project can be used for this purpose, for project management, to prepare the project management plan. MSP can be used. Then based on project planning, it is essential for day-to-day management. Okay, so project management plan is very much essential to track day-to-day activities and to plan accordingly, and it doesn't replace PMP. Okay, if you are using the schedule, okay, so using the schedule is okay, but the project schedule cannot replace project management plan. Okay, so both are different. PMP structure example. Okay, example of project management plan structure. So this is an example of PMP, that is a project management plan and its structure. So first, the project overview, which contains information about who is the customer. Okay, like say for example, one tire factory is the customer. Okay, so and its business domain is tires, isn't it? Automobile, it's a part of automobile. It belongs to automobile sector, isn't it? And what is the start and end date? So that means as per the schedule, when we are going to start the project and what is the delivery date? The delivery date is the end date. And what is the overall effort required? And what is the budget, that is overall value? Then main contact persons. That means whenever you want to deal with the client, to whom you should meet. That is major contact persons. Then project milestones. Example for project milestones is like user stories, requirements document, design document, source code. These are the milestones, and development environment. Okay, so this project overview will also clearly document what is the development environment. Say for example, I am going to use for development purpose Eclipse IDE. That's the development environment. Okay, like that. Then project planning. See, in PMP structure, the first point is project overview. Second point is project planning, which includes what is the process and tailoring. So project, that means which process model you are using. Okay, and if you are customizing, see always say for example, when we study waterfall model, we cannot assume that, so theoretically whatever that is been documented in the textbook exactly like that 100% industry is going to implement. No, they do certain modifications as per their requirement. Okay, that is called tailoring. Okay, that has to be what modifications that you are doing for waterfall model, say for example, that has to be documented. In case if you are using agile method, so what modification you are using for that. Okay, what little bit customization that you are doing for that agile methodology, that has to be documented. Then requirements change management, effort estimation, quality goals and plan, risk management plan, etc. So these things are documented as part of project planning. See students, these things just you need to mug up, okay, or just you need to keep in your mind. So project contain, overview means what are all the things it contains. Project planning means what are all the things, activities that comes under project planning, that you have to keep in your mind. Then under next, third point is project tracking. Data collection, analysis frequency. That means, so we see very frequently as part of project tracking, analysis has to be done. So what is the frequency of analysis? Whether it is 1 week, whether it is 5 days, whether it is 10 days, that has to be documented. Then escalation procedures. So Student, this is very, very important terminology. Escalation procedure. Say for example, there occurred one issue or a risk. Okay, one risk has occurred. Okay, now the project manager has to define clearly what are the limitations. Okay, to take the decisions, and what is the procedure that is to be followed to fix that particular risk. What is the mitigation plan? That is called escalation procedure. That means the escalation procedure will give you, okay, the boundaries and limitations of the particular risk and what is the procedure to overcome it. That is called escalation procedure. Next thing is status reporting. Okay, status reporting, that is like how much progress has happened. That is called status reporting. Then customer complaints. Project tracking also should address customer complaints. Say for example, say the overall duration is 1 year. So now 6 months has happened. So as per the schedule, you are supposed to implement 50% of the requirements, but only 47% of the requirements are implemented so far. So therefore the customer, there is a chance, not there is a chance, 100% the customer will raise the question. So that means say you have utilized 50% of the budget and 50% of the duration, but only 47% progress is been happened. So okay, that is an example for customer complaint. Then project team. Next is project team and its organization, roles and responsibilities. So project team, under project team there can be say so many sub teams, like the team that deals with requirement, and the team that deals with design and development, and that professional testing team, and the QA team, QA and automation. See, always QA team is one which will also take care of automation. Okay, and the responsibilities. Okay, that has to be documented as part of PMP. Overall project planning summary. Project planning forms the foundation of project management. Project planning forms the foundation of project management, and the key aspects of project planning are effort and schedule estimation, and quality planning, that means preparing the quality plan, and risk management means preparing the risk management plan. Then outputs of all can be documented in a PMP. That means outputs of project planning that can be documented in project management plan, which carries all relevant information about the project. Besides PMP, a detailed project schedule maintains tasks to be done in the project. So that is very important, because we know when you say schedule, there are two types of schedule. One is overall schedule and detailed schedule. See, the overall schedule is the static one. So once you define, okay, that data remains the same, but in case of detailed schedule, it keeps evolving as a progress, as the project starts progressing. Students, that's all about today's stuff. So remaining things we'll discuss tomorrow. Students, anything you want to ask about project management, risk assessment, project monitoring, PMP, and so on? Hello? Hello, students? Hello. Students, tomorrow I'll be starting a new chapter, which is once again part of Module 5. Tomorrow we'll be continuing Module 5, but we'll be starting completely a new chapter. Answer for your attendance, USN 1?
Yes, sir.
2?
Sir, he is present, sir. He has a network issue.
Okay. What is the date today?
6th July.
3? USN 3? Three absent. Four. Four.
Yes, sir.
Six.
Yes, sir.
Seven.
Present, sir.
Eight. Eight. Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten.
Present, sir.
11.
10%, sir.
12. 12. 13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir.
15.
Yes, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17. 17.
Put in chat, sir. Put it in chat box.
Okay, 18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21. 21. 22. 22. 23, 24,
yes, sir.
25,
present, sir.
26,
present, sir.
27,
present, sir.
28,
present, sir. Present, sir.
29, 29,
30, 30, present, sir.
31,
present, sir.
32.
30 present, sir.
32.
32 present, sir.
33.
Present, sir.
34. 35.
Sir, 34 present, sir.
35. 36.
Present, sir.
37.
Present, sir.
38.
Present, sir.
39.
Present, sir.
40.
Yes, sir.
41.
41 present, sir. Mic issue.
42.
Present, sir.
43.
Present, sir.
44.
Present, sir.
45.
Present, sir.
46. 46, 47.
Present, sir.
48.
Present, sir.
49.
Present, sir.
50.
49, present, sir.
Present, sir.
51.
Present, sir.
52.
Sir.
53.
53, present, sir.
54.
Present, sir.
55. 55. 56.
Present, sir.
7.
Present, sir.
58.
Present, sir.
59.
Present, sir.
42 present, sir.
Okay, 46, 46, 55, 35, 29, 23, 21, 8, 3. Okay, that's
49
it.
Present, sir.
Yeah, 49 present. Okay, students, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
We'll meet tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.